Hello all, we are the team Deimos of IIT Mandi, and here we present you the first version of our University Rover Challenge prototype. To realize this project, a team of 30 people subdivided in 4 different departments have been working for months. These 5 teams include mechanical, electronics, software, biological science and management.
To deal with the uneven terrain and provide enough stability, we have used a rocker bogey suspension system. The current design allows our rover to climb up rocks with 1.5 to 2 times the diameter of the wheels and to overcome an incline of 45 degrees. For steering, we are using a differential turning. Gear DC motors are used to power the balloon wheels. The motors are connected directly to the wheels and which enable the differential turning. The aluminium extrusion have been used as material for the chassis, which allows easy assembly, repair and change in chassis design if necessary. For the robotic arm, we have used a modified 6 degree of freedom Skira arm. The arm is powered by stepper motors and belt drives. The vertical movement of the limb is done by a lead screw mechanism, which allows precise and accurate linear movement. The end effectors are kept interchangeable, a scoop end effector for collecting soil samples. The equipment servicing end effector design includes a 2 degree of freedom wrist with a gripper. The IP cameras will be used in the end effector for the robotic arm and for assistive vision of the rover.
We have used Intel DLSense D455 RGBT camera as the main vision of our rover, which is mounted on a 360-degree rotating pole. As a central unit, we chose NVIDIA Jetson Nano, and for controlling other subsystems, we chose Raspberry Pi and STM32 boards. For navigation and orientation, the 9-degree of freedom IMU sensor is used with GPS. Intermodal communication is done through a network switch connected to communication module. Along with this, I2C and PWM is used for intra-module communication. Custom PCBs are designed for various subsystems. The power system is divided into power distribution system and power management system to power 5 subsystems: drivetrain, communication, manipulator, rover core, and science modules. A 24-volt LiPo battery pack equipped with a custom monitoring system is used. To establish the communication between the rover and the base station, we are using Ubiquiti Rocket AC light operating in the 5.8 GHz band, one omnidirectional antenna mounted on the rover, and one directional sector antenna at the base station.
The software team aimed to develop an easy-to-use GUI for teleporting the rover from the base. As a part of autonomous traversal, we developed an algorithm which uses a combination of automatry, IMU and GPS data to localize the rover. The depth data is used to map the environment, and the RRT-SAR algorithm combined with an obstacle avoidance algorithm is used for autonomous traversal. Both the map of the environment and the path to the goal are updated dynamically. When the rover is close to the goal location, we track the provided AR tag for planning an efficient path to the goal location. For controlling the robotic arm, we use the Movitros package. The depth camera is utilized to create a local map of the workspace, and this map is integrated with Movit to plan a collision-free trajectory. Live video stream from the arm camera is used to assist the teleoperator for controlling the arm.
To detect the presence of existing or extinct life forms, we have decided to go with 2 tests. First one is the CyberSafe gel staining, which will basically be going to identify the presence of either DNA or protein. We used an imaging system in the lab. We have created a similar mechanism to perform the task. Then the other test, Bure test, will differentiate between the proteins and DNA. We are also using a thermal camera to detect any temperature changes. All these tests will be on board. Onboard sensors and cameras provide necessary data on which ML models are used to make inferences. We used a pH sensor to measure the amount of alkalinity or acidity of soil solution. A moisture sensor to detect the amount of water in soil, which affects the biological processes. A UV rays detector was used to find the amount UV rays, a soil NPK sensor to detect amount of nitrogen, phosphorus and potassium in the soil, an anemometer to measure the wind speed, a spectral sensor for the spectroscopic analysis of the soil and for the physical properties of rocks such as absorbance and reflectance. The thermal camera will also be used to detect life, as the temperature of most life forms will be higher than the surrounding temperature. For detecting life forms, we have built a ML model for rock classification. We have built a custom CNN which is trained completely from scratch. The model does a 3-class classification into one of the three categories: igneous, sedimentary, and metamorphic. The model is giving an F1 score of 0.72 on testing data.
Each team is being guided by a team leader and has also been assigned some mentors who give their inputs from time to time. COVID-19 impacted the team in several ways: the delayed delivery timings, difficulty in accessing labs, increasing communication gaps, etc. All modules have been tested separately and the team has started integration of the rover. It took months of effort, dedication, time, curiosity, enthusiasm and zest for the team to reach where it stands today. We are all set to complete our rover in the given time constraints. Thank you for your consideration on behalf of Team Deimos.